My name is Rosemary Khamati. I'm the founder and director of Peace International, and our aim is to empower communities to do things for themselves. South Sudan broke into war in December 2013, and after that, hundreds and thousands of people started running away to find a safe place where they could live. And one of the places was Adjumani in northern Uganda. That's why they're in the refugee camps. The education and the school we are running in Oluwawan has been made possible through Fellowship Bible Church in Nashville, Tennessee. But you can see there are too many children in the classrooms. Some of them are in the villages because the classrooms are not enough. Out of the children who first came to this school, they graduated to go to grade one in a different school because we don't have the facility. That school is almost 5 kilometers away from here. And when you look at their ages, they are still too young to walk 5 kilometers to the school. Sometimes they go without having eaten. So by the time they get to the school, they are too tired, too hungry, so they cannot sit in class to learn. And they have to walk back another 5 kilometers. In the process, most of them have dropped out of school. So they have had no education except up to preschool. All of us have heard or know about the Lord's resistant army that abduct children and make them child soldiers. If these children did not come to school, they would have been abducted by now. Maybe not all of them, but some of them would be gone. So the importance of having this school here is to educate and also protect them. That side of the bridge is South Sudan, and this side of the bridge is Uganda. These people, because of the fighting that's going on, they are running away, and there is nothing you can carry when you are running away, fleeing from bullets. If they don't run, then they are going to be killed, and most of their relatives have already been killed. So they have nothing as they come. Father, we pray that your peace that passes all understanding will come upon her, and that, Lord God, you'll minister that peace into her life and into the lives of these grandchildren that she cares for. Father, we thank you for bringing them here safely, that, Lord God, they can testify of your goodness and your protection. This refugee camp has been in existence here for the past 2.5 months, and there are over 25,000 people living here. Now, this lady lives here, and the only thing she brought from South Sudan is this mat. She had two daughters who were married, and both daughters and their husbands were killed. Each one of the daughters had 3 children, so she ran away with the 6 children. So part of this mat is where all of them sleep. I would like the body of Christ at Fellowship to pray for me, because sometimes it can be overwhelming. The needs are too many. The pain is too much to bear alone. And I would like the body of Christ to embrace me and just pray for me to have the strength to continue doing what God has called me to do.